Good morning, students. Now we see the from your first chapter the important parts, that is rationalize the denominator. We have studied what is rational number, what is irrational number. Now we have to rationalize the denominator. Before that, we see the indices. If a is greater than 0, which is real number, a is greater than 0, which is real number, then nth root of a is equal to b, then we can write b raised to n is equal to a. So if a is greater than 0, which is real number, nth root of a is equal to b, then b raised to n is equal to a. In short, thus nth indices is equal to a, then square root of this number is nth root. So this you have studied. Now this we can write like this. Right, this is square root 9, this is cube root of 243. So this sign which we are making for that is called as radical sign. So this sign is called as radical sign. Generally we are related with the square root, that is this sign is called as, here no number is there, it is called as square root sign, or it is called as radical sign. So this is one important things in finding the rationalization of denominator. Now you are knowing what is rational number and irrational number. Rational number we can write in the form of p upon q, means in the form of fraction. Irrational number we cannot write in the form of p upon q. So we'll see. Now we have to rationalize the denominator. Now 1 upon root is the number whose denominator is not rationalized number, it is irrational number. So that we have to change into the rational number. So for that we have to do the process like this. Now the denominator is root 2, so multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number, means the denominator is root 2, so we have to rationalize it. So multiply this irrational number to the both numerator and denominator, so there is no change in the value because it becomes the equivalent fraction. So we multiply 1 multiplied by root 2 upon root 2 multiplied by root 2. So to make the denominator rationalize, we have to multiply the denominator, whatever irrational number is there, by that number you have to multiply numerator and denominator. Now any number is multiplied by 1, the answer is same number, so it is root 2, and this root 2 into root 2, that will come root 4, and root 4 you are knowing, square root of root 4 is 2, so root 2 upon 2. Now this is the rational number because this we can write in the form of numerator and denominator, so 2 upon 1. So this which is the irrational number, that now make the rational number here by using the equivalent fraction method. We multiply to the numerator and denominator by the same number, that is root 2. 1 into root 2, that is root 2. Root 2 into root 2, that is root 4. So root 2 as it is, square root of 4 is 2, and 2 is rational number. So in this way we have changed the irrational number in the denominator into the rational number. This process is called as rationalize the denominator. Now we solve some other examples of this, so you can understand how to make the denominator rationalize. Now next is 1 upon root 7. So we have to rationalize the denominator in this example. Now in the just last example we have said, now root 7 is the irrational number, so multiply numerator and denominator by same number. So 1 multiplied by root 7 upon root 7 multiplied by root 7, which is the irrational number in the denominator, by which you have to multiply numerator as well as denominator. So 1 multiplied by root 7, root 7 multiplied by root 7. So 1 into root 7, that is root 7, and square root this 7 into 7, that is square root 49, because we have studied the root. that root A into root B is equal to root AB. This root we have saved. So that root we have used. Root 7 into root 7, that is root 49. So by using this rule, now we got the denominator root 49, and you can find out the square root of 49. Square root of 49 is 7. So we have changed this irrational number into the rational number. So we have made the denominator rational number. That method is called as rationalize the denominator. So in this way, we can make the denominator convert into the rational number. Now we proceed to the next example from this. So the next is 1 upon root 7 minus root 6. 1 upon root 7 minus root 6. Now here, instead of one number, there is pair of irrational number, root 7 minus root 6. So now we multiply with the conjugate. Conjugate means opposite of that. Now we have split opposite. Opposite of minus 5 is plus 5. Like that, opposite of minus root 2 is plus root 2. So we will use this opposite standard method to make the denominator rationalize. So here we have to multiply by this root 7 minus root 6 to the both numerator and denominator. So we will get the rational number there. So we have to take the conjugate of, not conjugate means opposite side. So here now opposite of this is 1 into root 7 plus root 6. Conjugate of root 7 minus root 6 is root 7 plus root 6. Conjugate means, in short, that is make the opposite upon root 7 minus root 6 in second bracket root 7 plus root 6. So in this way, when the number is only one rational number, irrational number, then you can multiply the same number here. But the two numbers comes with the sign, then you have to take opposite of that. So here root 7 minus root 6, we have taken root 7 plus root 6, means this is called as conjugate. And we have multiplied by this conjugate to the numerator and denominator. So now next step will come, multiplied by 1, which will come root 7 plus root 6 and upon. Now we have studied the identity, that is A minus B into A plus B is equal to A square minus B square. We have studied this identity, A minus B, A plus B is equal to A square minus B square. Now here this is A, this is B, and both the brackets are same, but their signs are different. So root 7 square minus root 6 square. Value of A is root 7, value of B is root 6. So A square minus B square, so root 7 square minus root 6 square, root 6 square. And last step, root 7 plus root 6. When we are making the square of root, then it will come as the same number. So 7 minus, here root 6 square is 6, and 7 minus 6 is 1. So root 7 upon 6 upon 1. So we have changed the now denominator into the rational number. So in this way, we can rationalize the denominator. Now here, little bit change is there. When two numbers are there with sign, then you have to take opposite. Now here, minus is there. So we have taken the plus. Opposite of this, or this is called as conjugate. So root 7 minus is root 6. Conjugate is root 7 plus root 6. Root 7 minus root 6 into root 7 plus root 6. So multiplied by 1, the answer comes same. This is the identity, A minus B, A plus B. So answer is A square minus B square. So root 7 square minus root 6 square. When we are making the square of root, then answer is coming the same number. So root 6 square is 6. So 7 minus 6 is 1. In this way, we have rationalized the denominator. 1 is rational number because we can write in the form of numerator and denominator. So in this way, we can make the rational numbers in the denominator. That method is called as rationalize the denominator. Now next we'll see Guarapon, root 5 plus root 2. Root 5 plus root 2. Now here also, not only one is there, here 2 means 2 pair, two irrational numbers are there and they are added. So conjugate means opposite of that. So we have to take negative means root 5 minus root 2. And then we have to multiply to the numerator and denominator, or you can call it as opposite of this. So in rational numbers, it is called as conjugate. So conjugate of root 5 plus root 2 is root 5 minus root 2. So we multiply by this conjugate, 1 into root 5 minus root 2. We have not changed anything, only sign we have changed here. And down we are first root 5 plus root 2. In second bracket, root 5 minus root 2. So here multiplied by 1, it will come 1 only. And here again the same identity, a minus b, a plus b. So a square minus b square is identity you have to remember, which I said in the 8th standard, 7th standard. So here also root 5, here root 2, root 2. Only signs are different. So the numerator will come root 5 plus root 2 upon root 5 square minus root 2 square. So is equal to root 5 plus root 2. Okay, root 5 minus root 2 upon root 5 square is 5. When we are making the square of root, it comes as the same number minus. The square root of root 2 is 2. So root 5 minus root 2. 5 minus 2 is 3. So here we have made the denominator as rational number, where in our example the denominator was irrational number. So we change the irrational number into the rational number. That method we call it as rationalize the denominator. So next we see. Root 7 minus 2. Now here one irrational number is there and one rational number is there, but we have to multiply by numerator and denominator by its conjugate. So conjugate of negative is positive, so we have to multiply by root 7 plus 2 to the numerator and denominator. So 1 into root 7 plus 2 upon root 7 minus 2. Root 7 plus 2 means we are multiplied by conjugate. When more rational irrational numbers are there, we have to take conjugate and we have to multiply both numerator and denominator. So multiplied by 1 is same number, root 7 plus 2. Now here again a minus b and a plus b is there. So again the same identity, a minus b, a plus b means a square minus b square. So square of the first number, that is root 7 square minus 2 square. So root 7 plus 2 upon root 7 square is, now here only for first number the root is there, so it is square is 7, but here root is not there, so 2 square will become 4. So 7 minus 4, here root is there, that is why when we are making the square of this root, the number is coming same. But here, square root is not there, so 2 square is 4. And then root 7 plus 2 upon 7 minus 4 is 3. So, again we have changed the irrational number, which is the in the denominator, that is the rational number. So, in this way, we can change the given irrational number in the denominator in the form of rational number. We saw more examples from this, so you can understand. You have to remember the identities which we have studied in the 8th standard, and I also told when I was teaching this chapter to you. Now we saw the next example from this. 1 upon 2 plus root 3. 1 upon 2 plus root 3. So now we have to multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of these. The conjugate of 2 plus root 3 is 2 minus root 3. So 1 multiplied by 2 minus root 3 upon 2 plus root 3, which is at the same first, and its conjugate is 2 minus root 3. We multiply to the numerator and denominator by the conjugate in the conjugate of the number which is in the denominator. So conjugate of 2 plus root 3 is 2 minus root 3. Multiplied by 1 in the numerator, it will remain 2 minus root 3. Now again, this is identity, a plus b and a minus b. Both the numbers in the both bracket are same, only the signs are different. So answer of this a plus b and a minus b is a square minus b square. So our a is 2, so 2 square minus the b is root 3 square. So 2 minus root 3 upon, thus here no root sign is there, so 2 square will become 4 minus, but here root sign is there. So square of any root number is the same number, so 4 minus 3. So 2 minus root 3, 4 minus 3, that is 1. So in this way, by taking the conjugate of the given denominator, we have to multiply by conjugate to the denominator's number, to the numerator and denominator, and then we can, by using the identity which we have said, we can change the given irrational number in the denominator into the rational number. Next we see from your textbook. I hope that you are understanding the process which we are doing here. Now 5 upon root 3 minus root 5. 5 upon root 3 minus root 5. Now in the denominator, irrational number is there, that you have to change into the rational. So we have to take the conjugate of this root 3 minus root 5. So opposite means it is called as conjugate. So conjugate of this number is root 3 plus root 5. That is called as conjugate. So 5 into root 3 plus root 5 upon root 3 minus root 5 into root 3 plus root 5. We are multiplied by the denominator's conjugate to the numerator and denominator. Conjugate of root 3 minus root 5 is root 3 plus root 5. So we are multiplied by numerator and denominator by its conjugate. Now this is rational number and this is irrational number. So we can keep as it is because there is no any multiplication in that. Or maybe we can multiply 5 root 3 plus 5 root 5, but that is not necessary because we have to make only the denominator in that form. So 5 into bracket root 3 plus root 5. Now again, this is identity, a minus b, a plus b. So product of a minus b and a plus b is a square minus b square. So square of the first term, that is root 3 square, minus square of the last term, that is root 5 square. A minus b, a plus b is equal to a square minus b square. So root 3 square minus root 5 square. We have taken this as the identity. So multiply. So 5 into root 3 plus root 5. Now square of the root is same number, so that is 3, minus square of the again root, that is 5. So 3 minus 5, that is minus 2. So answer will come minus 5 upon 2. 3 minus 5 is 2. But 2 will go, sign will go up, minus 5 upon 2 into root 3 plus root 5. So again here, denominator we have changed into the rational number. So in this way, we are making the denominators in the rational number form. I hope that you are understanding what is going on here. Now next is 1 upon 7 plus 3 root 2. Now here opposite of this is 7 minus 3 root 2, which we called as conjugate. So to make the denominator rational number, we have to multiply with the denominator's conjugate to the numerator and denominator. So we'll multiply 1 into conjugate of this is 7 minus 3 root 2 upon 7 plus 3 root 2 into 7 minus 3 root 2. We have multiplied by the conjugate of denominator to the numerator and denominator. Multiplied by 1, the answer is same. 7 minus 3 root 2. Now here a plus b and a minus b. So I told you the identity, that is a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. This is the identity. So same type is there. Value of a is 7. Value of b is 3 root 2. So we have to make the square of a and b and in with a negative sign. So 7 square minus 3 root 2 square. A is 7 square minus 3 root 2 square. So numerator 7 minus 3 root 2. Now here no root sign is there. So 7 square will become 49. Now here for 3 square root is not there. So 3 square will become 9. But for 2 square is there. So when we are making the square of root number, then it will remain as it is. 9 into 2. 3 square is 9, the square of root, that will come 2 only, because root 2 is inside. So square of any number, root square root of any number is that number is only. So 7 minus 3 root 2 upon 49 minus 18. So 7 minus 3 root 2 upon 49 minus 18 is 31. So we have changed the given denominator, which is in the irrational form, we are converting into the rational number. So this process which we are doing, this that is called as rationalize the denominator, which is important in your Lysander different chapters. So I hope that you have understood this. We have solved these examples. Thank you.